Good morning one and all. Welcome to video tutorial of system programming and operating system. Today in this video tutorial we will implement Unix system call in C programming language. So in this lab assignment we will focus system calls like process status, fork, join, execute C and wait, which is used for process management. So basically system calls are nothing but it is an interface which are provided between user process and operating system in order to get some resources, hardware resources from the operating system. So whenever system calls are created, the context switching is take place between user mode to system mode. So when a program in user mode requires access to the RAM or hardware resource set, it must ask kernel to provide access to that resources, and this can be done using system call. So basically we are having several system calls for file handling, for process management, for device management, for information management, for communication and for protection. So for Windows we are having the system calls with create process, exit process, wait for signal object, like these functions. And for Unix we are having fork, exit and wait. So this kind of system calls which are used commonly in operating system. So the first system call that we are going to see is fork system call. So fork system call always used to create exact identical copy of child process. So when fork system call get called, then we are having two processes. One process is called parent process and other process is called child process. And remember one thing, that parent process always returns a value of child ID and child process is always return value as zero. So when a fork system call is called, there will be a return value will be written by that particular function is two value. One is child ID, which is written by parent process, and other is zero value, which is written by the child ID. And the number of processes created are always, it is in the range 2^n-1, where n is nothing but how many times we have called fork system call. For example, suppose we have called fork system call one time, then number of processes created are 2^1-1, which is equal to 2^1 is 2 - 1, so it is 1. So one child process will be created. Suppose we have called fork twice, then the number of processes, child process created are 3. So it is nothing but 2^2-1. So 2^2 is 4, 4 - 1 is 3. So 3 child process will be created. So in that case, parent process will return 3 child ID and 3 child process will return 0 value. The second kind of system call is process status command or process status system call. So this system call used to provide information about currently running processes, so or information about the task which is going to be currently running. So this process status information mainly include the four kind of attribute information. First is process ID, second is terminal type, third is CPU type, and fourth is command. So command is nothing but which process has created the current processes. So that information is going to be displayed. For example, bash shell. So these are the shell script or processes which are created the current processes. So later we can see that particular information while execution part of that particular program. Then we are having third kind of system call is join. So join command in Unix is basically used to joining two file contents, and that file contents can be, we can write into the third resultant file. So in order to join the two contents or similar contents from the two different files or the different content from two different files, so we are using this join command. Then we are having another system call as exec family system call, which is similar like your fork system calls, which is used to create a new process. But what is the difference between this fork system call and execute system call is that in fork system call we are creating exact identical copy of parent process, and at that time two processes are running concurrently in the operating system. If you are using execute system call, then this exe system call will replace old process and only one process, that is currently created process, will be exist in the operating system environment. So here parent process is killed by the new process, that is child process, and only child processes exist. In fork system call, both the child process and parent process is going to be exist in the operating system environment. So in fork system call, the common address space is going to be shared. In exe system call, common address space is going to be shared, but it is replaced by new process. Then another kind of system call that we are having is wait system call. So this system call is used for some implementation in your operating system. So in this, when your operating system calling a wait system call, then the old process or parent process has to be wait for child to get execute first. So in this situation, this wait system call is called. So first child process get completed and then parent process will resume its operation and it is going to be completed. So for this implementation, wait system call is going to be used. Now we will see the implementation of all these system calls one by one. So first system call is that we are having is process status status system call. So this is a very simple program, C program, which is executed for this PS system call. So the required header files that we have mentioned here, so these are the header files which are required for the inbuilt functions like system to be identified by your compiler. So this hash include system types.h, hash include unix standards.h header files, hash include standard input output.h. So these are the header files which are required for execution of this system call assignment. So first system call is process state system call, so which can be executed by using this function system double init comma ps. Now we will see the execution of this particular system call. So open the terminal and execute this particular program. So first we will list whether that particular file is there in our directory. So our file name is ps.c, so we will see that particular file is there or not. So ps.c is there, so this is our file, so we can execute that particular file here. So we'll give the name, we'll clear our terminal, we'll execute gcc ps.c. so it will give warning, so forget about that, ignore that warning and you continue. So this is the process status information. So basically it showing the currently running processes with their ID, terminal type, their time and which command initiated to create this particular process, that is process ID 6908 is initiated by bash command. Then process 6924 is initiated by a dot out process. So these are the information is going to be displayed using this particular system call. That system call is referred as process status system call. Now we are having another system call, that is our fork system call. So we will see the implementation of fork system call. So again we are writing the program by writing desired header files for the system call. Then we are calling fork system call here and we are storing that result into the one variable, that is var, and that result we are printing here. So now we will see the execution of this particular program. So we'll first list the file, whether we are having that particular file available in our directory. So our file name is example.c, so we will see example.c is there. So we'll execute that particular program gcc example.c .\a.out to run our program. So see here, now so it gives different output. It might be override by previous. So we will rename our file exam.c by some different name. We'll save this file as in home. I will save this file in home directory with e dot instead of example. I will save this file as e.c. e.c. Again, I will open the terminal and I will run the file. Now new file is gcc e.c ./a.out. See, so we have called fork only one, so one process is only created with id is 6974 and the child process will return value as 0. So parent process will always return the child process id, that is 6974, and child process will always return the value 0. So if you call this fork system called toys, then how many processes will be created? The number of processes which will be created are 2^2 - 1, that is 3 processes. That means there should be a 3 child id and 3 0 value, return value, that should be displayed. So we will see the demonstration of the same program. Here our file name is exam.c. so this is our file name, so that we are having ./a.out. So see here, the child process id are 90, 91 and 92, and these are the three values, zero values are written, 0, 0 and 0. So the number of processes are always, it is 2^n-1, where n is nothing but how many times you have called fork system call. So this is the simple execution of fork system call that we are having. Now next system call is, that we are having is join system call. So in join system call we require text1.txt. so you have to create one text file with any name. So I have given the name text1. Similarly, I have taken another txt file which name as a text2. So we will first open that particular text file here and we will see the content of that particular file. So text1.txt, so it is in desktop. The contents are my name is, then second line, this is my first, and the serial number is 12. Then we will put third serial number. This is my video tutorial. Then we'll save this particular file. Then we'll open another file, that is text2.txt. in that we'll put now third line as of spos. So we'll save this content. So remember one thing, in both the text file the first column should be common. So here first column is 1, 2, 3, that is serial number that we have taken, and in text2 also we have taken the common column as 1, 2, 3. So one column should be common, otherwise in your resultant file the empty file will be created. So we will see the implementation of this join system call in this. So gcc join.c our file name. So ignore the warning and continue. So you will get this particular output. Now we'll store this file. It is in desktop. This is in desktop. So we'll execute our program from the desktop. So I will change my directory to desktop, cd space desktop. Then I will execute the command gcc join.c. so it is not there. So we will save this program on desktop directory. save as join.c in desktop. So I will save. I will clear this terminal. Again I will execute join.c. So forget the warning and continue your execution. See, so first content is my name is, this is my first, this is my video tutorial, this is our first content of your text 1, then this is our second content of text 2, and the resultant file contents are the combination of my name is XYZ, this is from first file, this is from second file, this is from first file, this is my first assignment, and this is from, this is my first, is content of first file, and assignment of OS is second. So this is how join is going to be work. Then we'll move towards next system call, that is our wait system call. So in wait system call, always parent process will always wait for child process to get first completed. So how we can see its execution? So we will see. So first we list wait.c, wait.c. So there is error as there is no such a file. So we need to open new terminal. I will close and open new terminal. Wait dot c right dot forward slash a dot o u t. See here, the child process ID is 7175, then parent process ID is 7161. So parent process has to wait first to child get complete. So first process will be completed if child, so its ID is, the process terminated ID is 7175 because it is child process. So parent process will terminate after child process. So this is how wait system call is going to be used. Then now we need to implement all these functions combinedly. So for that purpose we are implementing this particular all the function using switch case. So here we have created case 1 as process state information system call, case 2 as fork, case 3 as wait, case 4 as excv, case 5 as join, and 6 as exist. So the same program I have combined here, so you can go through this program. So it will start with your required header files. So these are the four header files that are required. Then our main function, these are required variables. Then we are printing the menu, that is process state information for wait, execute v, join, exit, and you have to enter your choice. So enter your choice, then switch choice case 1. First case is to have process state information. Case 2 is implementation of fork system call. Fork system call. So if the process ID is greater than 0, then it is to get the parent process ID, we are having this inbuilt function get p PID. To get the child process ID, we are having the function get PID. So the child process ID we will get when the PID value is equal to 0, that is after successfully creation of your child, otherwise it will display the error. Then wait system call, that is case number 3, wait system call. So again we have used fork. So first we have created parent process and child process, and we have implemented this. Then excv system call, which is similar like your fork system call. So only difference between fork and excv is that The fork will always create new process and kept old process also alive. So simultaneously two processes will be exist in the operating system, whereas in EXEB only one process will be exist. The new process will be replaced old process, and old process is not going to be exist anymore in the operating system environment at a time. Then fifth is we are having is five is join system call. So we have created text file with name text1.txt. We have displayed its content. Then we have created the file text2.txt. Then we have displayed its content. Then before joining, what are the its content? The third resultant file that we have created is join.txt. And after performing the join operation, so this is the syntax for performing join operations: system join text1.txt, text2.txt, which results join.txt. After joining, we are getting this particular file and we are displaying that content. Case number 6 is exit. So we are printing simple one statement and default case that we are writing. So this is the whole program. So once you go through this particular program, implementation of Unix system call for execution of all these system calls in C programming language. So once you go through this whole program, now let's see to execute this particular program. So open the terminal. So first you list the file, whether that file is available, s.c, it is there. So we will clear the desktop. We will run the file gcc s.c. So line number 42, some errors are there that we will remove. Line number 42, so that is correct. So we will run. Through the desktop, so cd space desktop gcc s.c, then dot forward slash a dot out. So enter for child to see the output of process state system call. So it is going to be displayed. There are four currently running process, 7161, whose IDs are displayed here, and these are the attributes which will given by this process state system call: process ID, terminal type, time and command. Then we'll execute fork system call. So see here, the parent process ID is 7161, child process ID is 7296. As we have called only once, only one child will be exist. Then third is wait system call. So the child process ID is 7299, parent process ID is 7161. The first process will be completed is child, so the process terminate ID is 7299. So parent process will always wait for child process to get execute. Next is choice 4. It is similar like your fork system call. So only one process will be exist, that is 7301. Then we'll execute, that is fifth, that is join system call. So here the output of join system call, content of first text file. My name is, this is my first video tutorial. Then we are having text2.txt is xyz assignment of OS, then of spos, and the output is my name is xyz, this is my first assignment OS, this is my video tutorial of spos. The important point that you have to remember is there should be one common field. So here the common field is first column, that is 123 and 123 in second file. If you are not having common field, then it will give the join.txt as empty file as a result. Then we will exit, and if you put default choice also, so you have entered wrong choice. So this is how we have implemented a Unix system call in C programming. Now you have to implement the same, and you have to submit on this particular assignment on Moodle or our Gmail group. Thanks for watching.